Hello and welcome to the repair series. Some time ago I published this video where I explained how you can correct the angle of the fingerboard. There I said that there are two ways to change the angle. One was by putting a wedge under the fingerboard, and that is what I did in that video. And I also said that you can take the neck out of the body and correct it in that way by repositioning the neck in the body. And in today's video we are going to do that on this violin. As you can see on this picture, there is already a wedge under the fingerboard, but in my opinion it is too much. This wedge is about 5 millimeters thick, and I think that you can use this method if the difference that you are trying to compensate is maximal 2 millimeters. That's why I am going to take off the fingerboard. This fingerboard is also too thin, so I'm going to make a new fingerboard, and I'm going to take also the neck out of the body to reposition it in the correct angle. The neck is also a bit too long. It is a couple of millimeters longer than it should be, so I'm going to correct that also. And the last thing is that the neck isn't straight anymore in this direction. You can see also on this picture that there is a huge gap. So I'm going to make a new fingerboard, which is going to compensate that. As you understand, a lot to do. Let's get started. The first step will be to remove the fingerboard off the neck, and maybe also the wedge or the wedge, we will see. And I will use my knife to do that. That was a pretty easy task to do. Sometimes it's very hard to remove a fingerboard. Now we are going to remove the neck of the body. I will put a little bit of hot water to loosen up the glue. Finally, I have the instrument in one piece again. I have the neck and a new fingerboard. There was some collateral damage when I took the neck off the body. There were a lot of parts of the instrument that were not so well glued anymore. So the instrument looked a little bit like this at a certain point. But now the body is in one piece again, and I can go ahead. I made the fingerboard off camera because we are going to talk about the fingerboard later on in the violin making series. Now I'm going to glue the fingerboard back on the neck. And then I can start working between the neck and the body. And now we have to wait. The fingerboard is on its place. Now we are going to start working here. I've also put a bridge with an elastic band on the instrument, and that will help me direct the neck in this direction, so it goes nice and straight towards the middle of the instrument. At the moment it is going a bit too much towards the G string, towards the lower side. I want to correct it to go to the center, and it is a bit too high still, so we have to go a bit lower. I want to remove some wood on the upper side and some extra at this side, so that I can change the direction and it will go a bit lower. The neck fits correctly in the body now, so I'm ready with this. Before I glue it in place, I want to finish the fingerboard. As you see, the fingerboard is larger than the neck, but I want to make it straight again. I cannot make the neck larger, of course, so I will leave the upper side of the fingerboard as it is, and I will work on the lower side towards the neck. In this way, the upper side of the fingerboard will remain straight and the underside will follow the neck. The sides of the fingerboard are ready. That means that I can glue the neck on its place. And now we can wait again. The neck is dry, clamp can go off, and now I can work at the nut, which is the last part of this repair. As the neck had to go a bit deeper in the lower side in order to give some more height here, the nut is a bit too large now, and that means that I have to make it a bit smaller. And the instrument is ready. Fingerboard on its place, neck on its place, strings, pegs, everything works again. I have to tune it a little bit still. Okay, almost. Anyway, that's it for today's video. I hope you liked it. Like it if you did. Don't forget to subscribe so you won't miss the upcoming videos, and I will see you next time again. Bye bye!